live yet?
We just went live.
Okay.
So now's the time to say all the crazy things.
Can you see around me?
Yeah, I think you're all right. It's just Mark. Nobody would see him anyway.
He doesn't want to glare off his
The sun's on the outside. It hasn't sort of set in yet. I'm sure you can.
They do. You ought to get a half price.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, no, it's scheduled. You like the event or whatever. Oh, no, that one. No, it just went away. It's scheduled for May 19th. Oh, I've not heard about that yet. I know when I was talking to Joe about it, he said he was going to release a version of it before it went live. The one I went and found was not small. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. The old one covered health and safety mostly, and that was about it. Pretty much all he needed. He said, well, he was saying it was going to cover like political science. Okay. You know.
Would everyone please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
Well, if you're going to have something.
Dear God, as we gather tonight, we thank you for this wonderful town we live in, the people that we share it with. This council has always asked for strength, courage, and wisdom. And we thank you for the opportunity to serve this community. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. System that was completed in 2007. If they're in substantial compliance with one, I feel like they're fully in substantial compliance with the other. I need a motion as such. I make a motion that we approve CF1 real property for general show.
Motion been made. I have a second.
Second.
Motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Next item on the agenda is the compliance statement of form for the statement of benefits from Overton Industries.
This was the project in 2017 on the expansion of equipment. Total cost $94,000. Gentlemen, I need a motion to approve or deny.
I make a motion to approve the ordinance.
I'll second.
Motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Two companies that have been in the town of Mooresville for quite some time, and it's these types of companies that have built the reputation of Mooresville having strong industry, reliable employees, and a good community-based companies that look out for our community as well as we try to help them. I'm very grateful to have Overton Industries and General Shell in our communities. Mike, did you have anything on this?
No, I would just second what you said, Mr. President. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. On the agenda, we have Rick Callahan, PERC Superintendent. He here. Do you want to bring your colleagues here? Come on. Danny? Tim?
Is he a red one here?
Martin, the mirror.
Yeah.
Red.
I saw.
So I'm asking for the purchase of two utility cars that have been refurbished to be used at special events, both at the park, downtown, wherever those are needed. And they're would be a little more specialized than some of the just plain golf carts that we get to use for those. And I think it'd be a benefit for the park, and I also think it'd be a benefit for the community to have those to allow them to respond faster, get places that they can't other in quick order. And at the same time, we would probably be using those from time to time in the park for different things. The sheet that you have there explains what we were looking at. The new ones, two of them would be 16-4. And the ones that are completely refitted, they have all new bodies, heavy-duty suspension, oversized tires, wheels, new windshields, new multi-purpose rear seat, utility bed, LED headlights, and light on them. So they've been gone through. We went out and looked at them, drove them, made sure they could pull a hill and do things like that, and they appear to be about like new. They're equipped with they are gas. They're equipped with the two-cylinder Subaru motors.
Little top carry tire.
Top gallons of water.
You know, I'm not a fireman, so.
Are you bragging or complaining?
I would just be you to someone that knows that.
Gentlemen, when they came in and started talking of this, obviously you all know that my answer was no immediately. And the more they talked about them and how they could use them, Dan pointed out that Brent was always gracious enough to supply them with one of their rental carts, like for the old settlers. But as we're doing more and more at the park, we hope to do more and more at our bicentennial park. Brent saw this as a benefit for all of the town, including the park department. I was impressed that the three of them got together and looked at cost-saving factors. I think they went above and beyond, and I'm very proud of them for doing that when they found the equipment that they did. They're all three of them. I've asked them privately, and I've asked them together as a group, and all three of them seem to be satisfied with it. This is a purchase that we can make for the park through our food and beverage fund.
My question is, does it meet everything you guys need them to do for you? Yeah, we went out, we actually went to P&P Golf Cart, and we looked at some of the ones that they had out there, and our concern, you know, we want to be able to get people where they need to be, but we also want to be able to take the rear seats and put them down where we can carry EMS supplies, extinguishers, whatever we need. So the rear seats fold down and make it to a small utility type compartment. So they actually met and exceeded, I think, what our expectations are. If you look at them, the bodies, if you look under, we actually even looked underneath them as well, and they're made, you know, refurbished. So they're nice cars, and he sells a lot of them, and drove them, and
did the company have kind of guarantee or warranty for?
I think it was just like those vehicles we got from them. It was.
They're in better shape.
Yeah.
500 miles.
Yeah.
You bought the extended warranty on those.
Fine print.
But no, I think they'll certainly serve. And because, you know, with all the concerts here downtown was planned, and that was one of the things that we met on when we have a significant event that basically it'll tap the resources that we have for police, fire, and EMS. I think this is the best way that we can combat that, to get, especially on December's, is 3 days, but it's difficult as well. But add the concerts on top of that, I think, you know, to continue to keep renting those cars are probably not the best thing to do.
Did you say that this would be the last thing you drink gas for this year?
I will not say that.
We're very pleased.
Any more questions?
Got it. I'll make a motion that we approve the purchase in the amount of $9,400.
From
the beverage.
I'll say that.
Motion made and seconded. All in favor? Aye.
Aye. No, thank you.
Thank you.
I think do any of you want to give a report while you're up here? Go ahead. Give me a total.
What March?
Do you have a total?
Last month. Monthly report from March 2018. Incident reports, we have 290. Arrest reports, 96. Citations, 209. Warning citations, 505. CAD calls for the month, 2,664. 36 accidents, 32 property damage, 4 personal injury. Officer said over 200.5 hours in overtime, 61.5 hours in comp time, 26,744 miles driven for the month. Yeah, officer, attend breath test recertification. We had all the officers do their in-service training for the year. Finished it. Our K-19, the 3 officers did their in-service training for the month. And the 2 officers assigned to SWAT also did their training for the month. Move for report for March 2018. Busy. Any questions?
Would you advise the council on the one early warning siren that we have, what you have to do now?
And inspection.
I
did get with President Tom Wilden for our annual update on our outdoor warning system for sirens. We did have one that had a failure of the battery charger system. We had that replaced. All the other sirens tested.
January, we responded to 133 calls. February, 125. March, 144. And in April, we responded to 162. To break them down, it was 40 fires, 400 EMS calls, 14 hazardous conditions, 16 service calls, 67 good intent, and 24 false alarms to for a total of 564 year-to-date responses.
Any word at all on the fire trucks?
Yeah. Nothing to report. They shortened the engine a little bit, so we had to want to do a couple little modifications to that, but.
They shortened it?
Yeah, just the overall length. It was a little too long, so it's one of the a longer cab, and it obviously needed to be a little bit smaller, so.
Thank you.
The Boys and Girls Club has relinquished the moving contract, so we're going to be doing all five of the Mooresville schools with the before and after program. We're also going to be doing a summer camp program through that over at Neil Armstrong this summer, plus the summer program that we have in the park. And we've hired roughly 90 employees that will be working for us this summer at the different locations. So that's coming along real well. The summer concert series, we have all that done. I think we've got it on our website, but I'll make sure that we email out to each of you individually and go from there. One of the acts, most of them are locally known, or at least in this immediate region. The one on July 23rd is well known throughout central Indiana, so we're expecting a particularly large crowd for that. And as a backup on that one concert, we have the school auditorium booked. The school system worked with us on that, so we'll be able to do that in case the weather isn't fine. Otherwise, the acts that are, it's roughly every other Saturday night in June, July, August, September. If it's bad that night, that show will be canceled.
And do you pull the trigger on that?
Yes. Yes, we will. And I'll probably use these two guys to advise me on that.
Very open.
You're going to have to get with Brian on that. He's the karaoke specialist.
Other business, Mark had said that you were working on.
I think in front of you guys, we have a agreement that let's take a look at it. Hopefully you've already taken a peek at it. It's really a physical, your general services contract, personal services contract, however you want to say that. We talked about it the other day, and Anthony's already got the newspaper, which is getting ready to get the bid for the new police station. So. Basically, what I'd like to do is get an approval on this subject to a legal review, and then that gets done, and then also to have Tom approve that after the legal review is done. Joe and I will work through that with Sunco Construction. Long and short is, just one time, it's a cost-plus scenario. They will go in, they will do the bidding, and this is not entirely correct, but giving you the nuts and bolts. They go in, they'll bid the project, they obviously give the commission on that, they will guard the project, they will send bids out to the town of Mooresville, for example, once they bid or that they want to bid, we have that right to do that. And the rest of those agencies, as far as the bid goes, we'll bring those back here. It has to be open to the public, but we do open them. And right now, I just want to get this rolling, and we'll massage through the rest of that at the next meeting.
Mark, I know you had sent me that, and I did review it, but if you have another one of the paper copies, I didn't say anything, but like you said, I know that we need someone lots smarter than us to look at it.
Well, we don't have anybody much smarter than Bellsman to look at it.
I would add, after reviewing that, going through a construction project, the average cost usually runs about 10 to 15%. That was kind of shocked me at 7. So I think
we negotiated.
Yeah, I said that's pretty good. Pretty good. I was shocked you got it down that low. That was good.
Actually, I was told that Mark and Joe just stared at him and didn't say anything.
Or they promised to stay away.
Yeah, 3 hours later.
That's the problem.
Show me from again now.
But I'll say they've done some good work to get that down to that price.
Then I would need a motion to approve this pending legal counsel's blessing on it. If legal counsel makes any changes that are good with Mark and Joe, I would assume that we can move forward and sign this and get to running with it.
I'll make a motion that we approve it upon legal counsel's approval and make Tom the signatory of that document.
Yeah, we have. It's good. We have it for more.
Second.
Motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thanks, gentlemen.
Actually, that's not what I was talking about, but you had enlightened me or told me earlier today that you had reached out, made some contacts on the Sammy Davis project.
Nothing really at this point in time significant to report.
Okay, I knew that's what you said, but I just wanted to know because it was on the agenda.
Okay.
Members of the council have anything? Okay.
A couple of meetings ago, I brought up possible property maintenance ordinance. I've given everybody a copy of it. So okay. If I wanted to look over the pictures, seems like it might fit us pretty well. It was probably something that more take in it.
Can we review this and bring it at our next meeting?
Yes.
I knew that you had talked about this a couple meetings ago, and it's kind of exciting. I know it's a very sticky subject, so we'll move to that and see what we've got. We discuss it at our next meeting. Anything else from council? I had a contact, and I spoke with Dave Moore. Dave Moore spoke with some a representative from the school on some issues that we're having with water, obviously everywhere, but at the Circle Drive, one of the observations that have been made was a lot of that is backing up into that area, and our projects as far as our cleaning of our ditches, swells, and tributaries may alleviate a lot of that. When they reach out to the school, they're willing to work 100% of whatever they need to do, so we are moving forward on that. The other thing that we did receive an email from Representative Mayfield. It was in regards to House Bill 1070. Peggy's championed this bill for 3 years. This year, she finally was able to get a foothold, and with cooperation from Representative Young and Representative Benning, and sponsored in the Senate with Robert Bray. It gives, for the first time, Northern Morgan County voting rights with the Indianapolis Airport Authority. We've always had a non-voting member on that board, and thanks to her diligent work, our member, our representative, will now have a vote on that board. That will take effect July 1st this year. And I would like to personally thank her, and I think this entire council would probably echo the fact that that is something that we have wanted. Two things come to mind. It gives us the opportunity to have some input, but it also, if you're going to take credit, you've got to take partial blame. So it gives us some responsibility there. Currently, our non-voting member on that board has done an outstanding job bringing back information to us, and I think we'll work very well for the town of Marshall.
Yes.
Legal counsel.
The only thing I have tonight, I brought this evening a new engagement letter for the new law firm Taft. It's 95% the same as the other one, so a little thinner. Just a little bit. Fees remain the same. I assume that would be of some significance.
seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Since we approved it on first reading, do we get a discount?
That's what we ever say to our attorney, Tom. Do we get a discount?
You have anything else?
No, that's all.
Comments from the floor? We have Shane. First of all, I'd like to thank the council for getting the torch. It looks like at least the North Gateway and the big torch hadn't been to the South Gateway, but it looks a lot better with the new lighting. I think they more may have been than I know, but it looks a lot nicer. I think people will be a lot more satisfied with it. So thank you for that.
Yes.
Also, I have the house at 10 Circle Drive, which is right on the Indiana Street ditch. If there's anything I can do to assist you in the water problems, let me know.
Doug Lord, so you, Aunt Bertie?
Yes,
Bertie's next to you. And he was real nice about it. And then, like I said, something that I had not thought about, but the gentleman from the school and then also Dave Moore said, you know, we think a lot of that's backing up into that. So, you know, that's part of our project is to get that water out of there quicker. I think what it's doing is it's backing up all the way from the end of it and yeah. backing up there.
If there's anything I can do to help you, you let me know because we want to solve that water problem for people in town.
And especially the basement.
Ours is a crawl.
So no basement.
No. can you dig a bigger sump pit? If you want to buy my house and make a retention pond out of it and talk to me about it, I hope people cooperate with you on the easements and access to the property with the water because that's important. So I hope people do that. Quickly, I noticed that the department heads were here today for multiple reasons, or part of the department heads. And I'm really proud of for mentioning it, but back in February, on February 7th of 17, Jack Ferry submitted a formal motion that was adopted 5-0 to have them report monthly in front of the public. And last meeting, Dave Allen asked about it, and it seemed a little fuzzy as to whether that was continued, and I don't think that motion's been amended in public and readopted or whatever you want to revoted on. So I just want to clear that up. Are they going to report monthly?
I think what we've done in the past, and you know, just like Dave not being here tonight, I think Dave is probably doing something for the town as we speak.
Yeah.
And you know, through the winter months, we've had just about something going on every night somewhere. Obviously, the gentlemen were all here because we had a group project, and that's the part that I'm really excited about is the three of them work together extremely well. All of them have given us each reports. I think that the reports here obviously are a good public relations factor, even though it doesn't sometimes makes sense when they tell us how many runs they had or anything like that. And sometimes when you see them in writing, like the police department talking about having so many citations, but yet maybe twice or three times the number of warnings, tells us that, hey, you know what, we are trying to let the public know that we are out here, we are working for them. So to say that I can guarantee you they'll be here every meeting, I think if we do anything, it may be instead of having each one of them or the total of them here, we may have one of them here every meeting, but not necessarily.
It just said they were going to report once a month. It doesn't say they all have to report at the same meeting, just once a month.
Well, I think all of our department heads do an outstanding job, but sometimes we put a little more on them than what we should. The report part of it, I'd like for them to come in just to be able to be their cheerleader. It's nice to have the public acknowledge how hard they do work for us as citizens.
So,
but as the You passed the motion. Yes, the motion needed.
Oh, I thought it was a great deal when we did it before. I thought it was a great deal when they did it before, but on the same token, I think Chief Allen is here at every meeting.
Right.
And does not turn in overtime for that. Thank you, Dan. But, you know, I think if each one of them, I would like to see each one of them, maybe not every month, but on a cycle of each member coming. To say that at that time the motion was made, I'd like to see that, and I said I wholeheartedly would too. To say that I demand that they be here, I don't know that I would go that far.
I think the motion would need to be a re-vote, to re-discuss and amend it, because it says they're going to be here once a month. I mean, otherwise, no motion matters. I'll submit my letter to you. If you wouldn't mind responding to me, I can submit it to you or to the legal counsel. And then
Okay.
Thanks.
But tell them thank you like you did. I appreciate what you said. Thank you, too. You're welcome.
Everyone should also remember that the police commission, there is a police commission meeting that you can get this information, and also a department board meeting you can get press information. So it's not just the town council. In fact, they do have different boards that they really report to. And, you know, we might get to the point that maybe they should go hear that at the police commission and the department versus the town council. I'm not saying that that's how I agree with it, but that is another option. There are park board meetings and there are police commission meetings. So you can also go hear that information there as well.
Legal counsel advised me to get something else.
We had an item, I apologize, Mr. President. After the last meeting, or at the last meeting, it brought to my attention that Brian Hanger was struggling with getting easements on that drainage project because they were, at that point, they had forms for temporary easement and permanent easement, and no ability to cross public property to get to temporary easements, that sort of thing. So shortly after that, I said I prepared for him an easement document that encompasses all three of those documents. I just sent it directly to him, so he's utilizing that to expedite that drainage project. It's pretty complicated with three documents for every property owner.
Dave's picking up the easements tomorrow.
I know that Mr. Lawrence also reiterated that if we have any trouble with any of the people, that he would love to come and talk to them. And I think that's the people that have been affected are concerned with that.
That's all of it.
Any more comments from the public? Gentlemen, I need a motion to approve payment of claims.
Make a motion that we approve claims in the amount of $322,704.78.
If you check the document, it's kind of more documents.
Have a motion to have a sale.
Second.
Make a fix, Andy Jorah, while we was used since then.
Gentlemen, we are going to put on the agenda for our next meeting discussion of this letter. I will have copies, standing bank copies, and circulate to you. While I understand the point of it, it does go back to, and I did say at that meeting that I would like to see the reports, and I think it's a good thing. But we will discuss it at our next meeting. Motion made and seconded on the claims. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Motion for adjournment.
I'll make said motion.
Motion made. Do I have a second? Guys, for lack of a second. Motion made, seconded. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Thank you very much to the public.
What's the next meeting?
Oh, good point. Next meeting is May 15th, 2018. What time would you like to do it, ma'am?
Same time as last time.
6:30?
6:30.
Thank you.